Namaste, I'm Dipanshi Kapoor of the Shri Ram School Aravali, and I feel strongly about the impact on mental health of adolescents, of the obsessive need of humans to win in every task they are a part of. How many of you have participated in a race? How many of you have started the race with the intention to win? And how many of you have celebrated the fact that you were the last person to cross the finishing line, or perhaps your friend was the one who reached there a second before you? This brings me to talk about an issue which is prevalent in today's world, especially in the minds of young adults, as they call us. Competition, a word that fuels passion, energy, conflict, jealousy, nervousness, and evokes many other emotions in one mind. The moment you stand at the starting point, or the moment you begin a particular task, your primary focus is not on achieving it. It is on the need for success or the attainment of excellence. The initial step towards failing or succeeding begins with one's basic urge to leave a mark or that of being remembered and admired by others. This is when the seed of competition is sown in one's mind, and this force behind all the actions of an individual to succeed in almost every task, known as achievement motivation, has both positive as well as negative impact. In a world where renowned companies and personalities are constantly fighting against each other in order to highlight their talents and ideas, to regard competition as an incorrect method of achievement will not be well accepted. Therefore, I say that competition isn't entirely bad. In fact, it motivates you to achieve your goals. However, competition in this day and age has intensified to a limit where anyone is ready to do anything in order to win, or sometimes even in order to see someone else lose. I feel that competition has had a negative influence on the minds of adolescents in many ways. Negativity and stress. As a result of competition, there's an obvious social comparison where students compare themselves with their classmates, and that makes them doubt their potential. They're constantly under the pressure of being better than others, and soon a normal quiz turns into a battle of egos. Magnification. They do not leave a single opportunity to prove that they are better than someone else, and after a point, every decision they make reflects their jealousy. Apart from these two effects, there are cases where competition causes anxiety, depression, and loneliness. These issues are extremely sensitive and cause adolescents to choose incorrect methods in order to get rid of this depression. A survey of 52 graduate students in the Hungary Neuroscience program revealed that most of them deal with stress and mental health problems. The data from the American College Health Association revealed that most of them deal with stress and anxiety and depression. These consequences can be avoided by perceiving their cause, that is competition, very differently. In the midst of winning and losing, we often forget the true meaning of success and the difference between winning and succeeding. To win may sometimes mean to secure first position in a contest. However, to succeed means to achieve an aim or goal that you've set for yourself. It is important to realize that how important it is to minimize the pressure that forces us to achieve success in whatever we do. Instead, focus on self-satisfaction and self-motivation. The chart offers tips by the American Psychological Association in order to reduce stress. Look around you, the lights, the fans, the stage, this room. It all began with an idea, a dream. A dream to make a difference, a dream to make something of important use, and a dream to be remembered. That does not mean that these people did not face any difficulties during the process. Let's talk about Thomas Edison, who was famous for inventing the light bulb, but also famous for embracing failure. He said, and I quote, "I have not failed 10,000 times, I have not failed once. I've succeeded in proving that those 10,000 ways will not work. When I've eliminated the ways that will not work, I will find the ways that will work." Similarly, we have to ignite the spark within ourselves that pushes us to achieve success in whatever we do by using methods that focus on self-improvement, self-satisfaction, and cooperating with others. Thank you.